You know we're gonna be late, right?
We have like 5 minutes.
Anne, 2 minutes.
Oh gosh, gotta keep going.
And the worst part is we're not even like dressed for this.
That's okay, we'll get dressed for this in.
Live from the TV studio of Marywood University's Learning Commons, it's Late Night Marywood. Welcoming tonight's special guest, Marywood student Ryan Calamia and singer-songwriter James Barrett. And here comes the procrastinators themselves. Please welcome your hosts, Rachel Eiler and Anne Zukowski.
Good evening, Facebook and Comcast viewers. Thank you so much for joining us here again at Late Night Marywood.
Wow, it's already week 4 of our show, and honestly, it's been going by really fast.
Yeah, you're so right. I mean, last week we started talking about midterms, and now midterms week is finally here. But everyone should have something to look forward to because, you know, spring break starts Friday, and I don't know about you, Anne, but I will be in my car on the way back to New York by 1:01 p.m. right after my class.
Yeah, I'm already packing up my dorm and making sure that I can get off campus as soon as my midterms are done. But first, I need to get through all my midterms.
I totally feel you. I know last week we started talking about also the number one way to get through big, long study sessions is coffee. It's really funny, actually, because back in high school, there was a Dunkin' Donuts across the street from us. And during midterms week, that's all I would drink was just Dunkin' Donuts.
Wait, what? Did you say Dunkin'?
Yeah, why?
Because you clearly have not passed all the coffee tests because Starbucks is way better.
Oh, Anne, not this again. Really? How so?
Well, for starters, Dunkin' is very watered down. It's mostly only like ice, which is not very good to have all the time. And the flavors are kind of weak.
Well, that's because it's also bitter at Starbucks. I mean, Starbucks, you guys have so many flavors, but they're so bitter and disgusting. They're just like, I don't know, your coffee just doesn't have any flavor to it.
Every time we go to Dunkin', I'm pretty sure that I always have something wrong with my order. At Starbucks, they're pretty loyal to their customers and they'll make sure that the order is right.
Yeah, loyal as in $5 for a small coffee.
You're getting a good quality coffee.
I wouldn't tell. I mean, you guys are really, really high in sugar.
I don't really think so.
I really think so.
Because our flavors are a lot better. So
not really. Low calorie. Anyway, we're going to have to talk about this later. I'm going to carry on now if that's okay with you. My point is, America doesn't run on Dunkin'. Rachel runs on Dunkin'.
Well, all you had to say was that.
Well, besides coffee, I was going to show them my study tips for midterms, if that's okay.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I think you should.
Okay, Anne, I think we might need to cut you back on the coffee lately, but let's take a look at my study tips.
Make sure you find a quiet study room. This one looks pretty quiet. Take out everything you're gonna need to study. So your textbooks, your notebooks, flashcards, study guides, whatever you have, take it all out and organize it on the table. I like to keep my workspace clean and organized, so try and line up all the textbooks that you're gonna study. Once you're situated, get comfortable. You're gonna be there a while. Maybe even grab a cup of coffee. Now that you have your coffee, take a sip and get ready to focus. Before I even open a notebook, I like to write down all the things I have to do and then also put on some music. Okay, now on to the actual studying part. I like to go back and look at all my highlighted notes. Something that always helps me study is actually using bookmark sticky notes to mark down important things that I read. Definitely take notes from what you are reading. This will really help you during midterms week and it will refresh your memory of what you learned. Now, you may have some self-doubt while studying.
Wait, did we read this? Wait, I don't remember reading this. It's highlighted. It has sticky notes next to it. Wait, I don't remember reading this. Is this gonna be on the test?
If that happens, just don't do this.
I'm never gonna get a 4.0. I'm gonna lose my scholarship. I'm gonna get an F on this. I mean, I might as well just quit now. Please help me. You can do this. You got this. Power to you, man. We're gonna pass this test.
The important thing is just to refocus and get back into it.
Focus, focus. I got you. You and me, we're gonna get this going. You got this. Okay.
Make study cards to help you remember key terms for a test. Or just get a whiteboard and write it all down. Writing is always the best way to memorize something. Follow these study tips and you'll be sure to get a good grade on that midterm. Good luck, everyone.
Oh, Rachel, that was some really good advice.
I know. And that's not even how my normal study days go. I mean, that's like every single day, that mentality especially.
Well, we'll be thinking about you as we're studying for midterms, but we're going to take a short break and take in all of Rachel's tips. Stay tuned.
You know what, guys? There's a lot of tree branches and dry brush over here. We should probably move the bonfire over there.
I'm guessing Smokey liked that idea.
You've messed up your son's haircut.
Mom?
Do you A, try to fix it?
Like it never happened.
B, work with what you got? Or C, show solidarity?
As a parent, there are no perfect answers. But you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
There are 16 million children struggling with hunger in America. That's 1 in 5 daughters, sons, neighbors, and classmates who don't know where their next meal is coming from. Yet billions of pounds of good food go to waste every year. It's time we do something about it. Feeding America is a nationwide network of food banks that helps provide meals to millions of kids and families in need. Visit feedingamerica.org to help them feed even more. Together, we can solve hunger. Together, we're feeding America.
This is the story of a boy who is very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where nothing could get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. It made him feel uncomfortable. One day, he found out he had something called autism. His family got him help, and slowly, he learned how to live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
They said I have troll teeth.
That my voice sounded like a possessed baby doll.
That no one would ever love someone as stupid as me.
That I was fat, ugly,
disgusting.
The effect of bullying is potent.
We will no longer be the silent majority.
Now, when you see online bullying, there's something you can do about it.
We're gonna take action with the eye.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness, and so are you.
So who's gonna do what?
I'll pack the dead batteries.
Great.
I'll only put what I don't need into a duffel bag.
Perfect. That's totally unhelpful.
No problem.
Meanwhile, I will try to comfort everyone by speaking in a calm voice.
And who is going to handle supplies?
I can forget to do a list for us.
Thanks, pal.
We couldn't be any less prepared. I'm proud of you guys.
Talk to your kids about who to call, where to meet, what to pack. Visit ready.gov/kids for tips and information.
Welcome back to Late Night Marywood. While Rachel had some good tips to prepare for midterms, I'm more excited for spring break.
Oh, I'm so excited. I mean, we finally get to catch up on all the sleep we missed during that first half of the semester. Actually, the other day I was scrolling through Facebook and I saw a list of majors who get the least amount of sleep and the most amount of sleep. It was really interesting because I'm sure, as like a lot of people know, we all kind of guess architect majors, but according to the website, actually tab.com, architect majors are ranked at number 1 with 5.5 hours per night for sleep.
I'm sure if you go ask any of the architecture majors here at Marywood, they would probably agree that they probably get even less than that.
I mean, I think we can kind of argue for our major too. I mean, we're communications, but I mean, I'm mostly journalism. But it was really interesting because I scrolled down to find our major and we actually kind of get more than what they say. Communication students, or journalism students really, are ranked toward the bottom of the list with 7 hours of sleep per night.
7 hours?
I know,
are
right?
you sure? I'm pretty sure I at least get an average of maybe five hours per night.
Yeah, I mean, I know I get about 4 to 5 during the week, but hey, 6 hours yesterday.
Thank God for weekends, right?
Exactly. But I mean, more I think about it, just imagine all the sleep I'm finally going to get over spring break.
Yeah, it's something to look forward to. It is your first college spring break, so is sleeping all you're gonna be doing?
I mean, not exactly. I'm kind of getting my wisdom teeth out too.
Wow, that's so much fun.
I know, right?
You should probably enjoy your spring break, relax, sit back, enjoy your time off from school, make it like a second Christmas.
I mean, I could probably do that. It could be more like the 12 days of Christmas, except 7, because I mean, we only get a week. But
you should make it a goal to do 7 things in each day.
I mean, I could only begin to imagine where I'd start.
On the first day of spring break, this is what I'll do. Sleep until I'm fully rested. On the second day of spring break, this is what I'll do. Go for a hike and sleep. Day of spring break, this is what I'll do. Visit my old high school, go for a hike, and sleep until I'm fully rested. On the fourth day of spring break, this is what I'll do. Binge watch Netflix, visit my old high school, go for a hike, and sleep until I'm fully rested. On the fifth day of spring break, this is what I'll do. Watch all Harry Potter movies. Binge watch Netflix. Visit my old high school. Go for a hike and sleep until I'm fully rested. On the sixth day of spring break, this is what I'll do. Catch up on my assignments. Watch all Harry Potter movies. Binge watch Netflix. Visit my old high school. Go for a hike. Sleep until I'm fully rested. On the last day of spring break, this is what I'll do. Cry, cause it's over. Catch up on my assignments. Watch only Harry Potter movies. Binge watch Netflix. Visit my old high school. Go for a hike. And sleep until I'm fully rested.
Now that's what I call a spring break, catching up with sleep, catching up on Netflix, visiting old friends from high school.
Yeah, see, I mean, no need to worry about my fun that I'll have. Coming up later tonight, we are having even more fun right here. We have Marywood student Ryan Kalamia and local musician James Barrett. So stay tuned and we'll be right back on Late Night Marywood.
So who's gonna do what?
I'll pack the dead batteries.
Great.
I'll only put what I don't need into a duffel bag.
Perfect, that's totally unhelpful.
No problem.
Meanwhile, I will try to comfort everyone by speaking in a calm voice.
And who is going to handle supplies?
I can forget to do a list for us.
Thanks, pal.
We couldn't be any less prepared. I'm proud of you guys.
Talk to your kids about who to call, where to meet, what to pack. Visit ready.gov/kids for tips and information.
Alvin and the Chipmunks want to remind you, bacteria can hide in food and make you ill.
Wow.
But you can keep bacteria from ruining your day with 4 simple steps. Clean.
I'm waiting for the rinse cycle.
Separate. Cook.
Fire in the hole.
And chill.
We chipmunks are notoriously tidy.
Check your steps. The road trip to food safety starts at foodsafety.gov.
There's one thing you can never have sex without.
It's not something you buy.
Or something you take.
In fact, there's only one way to get it.
It has to be given to you, freely.
It's consent.
Because sex without it isn't sex.
It's rape. Consent.
If you don't get it, you don't get it. It's on us to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Right, mi cariño. So like I said, everything I learned about cooking, I learned from grandma's empanadas. Shall we go again?
Yep.
Mix beef with the onions with the peppers with the paprika, the garlic with the oregano with the cumin. Got it?
Got it.
Throw in the olive, stir, season, stir again, pour out the flour, roll out the dough, make a circle, drop in a fistful of filling, fold over, press down, and ta-da!
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day making sure they brush is easier, and it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain.
You think getting dumped by text is harsh? Try getting dumped by tennis ball. My ex-owner drove me out to the woods, yelled fetch, and by the time I brought the ball back, he was gone. Yeah, I was pissed. But the folks at the shelter helped me let go of my anger. I learned coping skills, like taking it to the hole. Boom! Now I'm ready to fetch again. But how about I throw and you run and get it?
Todd's a great guy. I mean, look at him. What a sweetheart. Attaboy. Wait, Todd, what are you doing? How totally selfish and un-Todd-like of you. Come on, Todd. Come on, man.
Welcome back to Late Night Marywood. So last week we took a look at Marywood graphic design major Emmanuel Ajay, and today we have another Marywood student joining us.
He is a sophomore education major originally from Central New Jersey. On campus, he is a member of Student Government Association, a student admissions ambassador, and an advocate for the LGBTQ community, and has contributed to the Marywood chapter of her campus. Please welcome Ryan Kalamia. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you for having me on here. This is awesome.
I'm really excited. I mean, I'm education. I don't know if you remember this. Actually, you were my tour guide last year.
Wait, was I really?
Yeah.
I don't remember that, yeah, but thank you for reminding me.
It was so awesome when I realized it was you, and I'm like, oh my gosh, it's the education major.
I guess he did a good job.
You did a good job.
I guess I did a good job.
Yeah. So education, let's just start with that. I mean, how'd you get involved with that?
My whole family is made up of teachers. My dad's two older sisters and my mom's older sister all are teachers and everything. And so it was kind of just something that I also felt a passion for. And I also was taught karate to all ages for 4 years. And I was in Boy Scouts as well. So I led our troop and patrols and stuff. So it was kind of just like a natural thing for me to move into.
Cool. So yeah. You're also from New Jersey, just like myself. Can you tell us a little bit about why you decided Marywood?
Marywood won the campus. The campus was just beautiful when I came. The leaves were changing colors, and I like stepped out of the car, and I was like, this is it. Like, I compared every other school that I went to Marywood. And then it was also the programs. They had a really good English program, and when I originally came here, I came for early childhood, and they had a really good five-year program as well.
So what exactly do you want to do after college, even though you're only a sophomore? Have you thought ahead?
I want to teach high school English. I want to move out to California and end up teaching out there, get my master's in education, hopefully at a grad school in UCLA. So.
That's awesome.
Yeah, nice list of goals. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do in student government?
Student government, I am the class of 2019 senator. I handle problems or concerns that my class specifically has that I can convey to the student government, as well as just helping out with student government as a whole and making the campus better.
Great. So, I mean, you are very highly involved in campus. So how do you kind of tie in your major to what you do around the school?
A lot of things that I do is just like leadership-based qualities. I try to lead as much as I can and like just hone in that skill so I am able to teach when I'm in a high school.
That's great.
Yeah.
So with student government and even you being a student ambassador, how does it feel holding those positions already as a sophomore?
It feels really good. It means that like I am putting myself out there and that other people trust me, so then I will be able to take on more through my years here at Marywood. So I really like that.
awesome. Well, you clearly are making an impact. I mean, last year, I believe you actually did a spotlight. You were asked to do a spotlight for her campus.
Yeah.
What has that been like?
It was really cool. Katie Wheeler interviewed me, and it was really interesting just talking about like my interests and everything and like what I'm doing and being able to like just have a voice out there. I think is really cool.
Great. So what exactly in the spotlight did you talk about?
I just talked about my major and like what I want to do with it and if there was anything specific that I really had in mind, I guess. Yeah.
So what are some goals that you personally have for Marywood or your future?
I definitely want to leave an impact in Marywood and make it a place where everybody feels welcome and included. I definitely want to help improve it so that when people come here, like, this is their instant first choice.
What would you say has been, like, your biggest aspiration or something that really inspires you and motivates you to do that every day?
I think it's, as cliche as it sounds, I think it's my parents. They've done a lot for me. They've been there throughout my entire life, very supportive in all my decisions and actions that I decide to do. And I'm really proud that I can show them all these things that I've done with their guidance, basically.
Awesome. Yeah, I mean, yeah. I'm sure you're gonna be a great teacher. And I mean, you kind of said this before, but how do you think that you are gonna impact a student one day?
I definitely want to empower them to go and chase whatever dreams they have. Nothing is too big or too small to achieve in this world. All you have to do is just put forth the effort and go to it. And that's what I've done my entire life, and I want my future students to do that. I want them to feel inspired to go out and become the next great doctor or discover cancer or the cure for cancer, not cancer. But just kind of go out and experience life in their own way and make what they want of it.
Wow, that's awesome.
Really inspirational.
This is a great start, and we are going to take a break, but don't go anywhere, because when we come back, we're going to talk more about Ryan's involvement on campus, so stay tuned.
Todd's a great guy. I mean, look at him. What a sweetheart. Attaboy. Wait, Todd, what are you doing? How totally selfish and un-Todd-like of you. Come on, Todd. Come on, man.
You're doing great. We're gonna try this again, okay?
Okay.
Wheels, pedals, handlebar, brakes. Sit up straight, keep your weight in the center, keep your eyes on the road, hands on the grips, button the seat. If we feel ourselves falling, what do we do?
Just keep pedaling.
Good girl. Now remember, it's all about balance and steering. Steer with your hands, steer with your body. Steer into the corners and you stay out of trouble. And the bell's your buddy, so go ahead and ding that. All right, ready? Here we go. Pedal, honey, pedal. There you go, you're a bike rider.
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day making sure they brush is easier, and it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain.
You know what, guys? There's a lot of tree branches and dry brush over here. We should probably move the bonfire over there.
I'm guessing Smokey liked that idea.
You've messed up your son's haircut.
Mom?
Do you A, try to fix it?
Like it never happened.
B, work with what you got? Or C, show solidarity?
Thank you, babe.
As a parent, there are no perfect answers. But you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
There are 16 million children struggling with hunger in America.
That's one in five daughters, sons, neighbors, and classmates who don't know where their next meal is coming from. Yet billions of pounds of good food go to waste every year. It's time we do something about it. Feeding America is a nationwide network of food banks that helps provide meals to millions of kids and families in need. Visit feedingamerica.org to help them feed even more. Together, we can solve hunger. Together, we're feeding America.
This is the story of a boy who is very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where nothing could get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. It made him feel uncomfortable. One day, he found out he had something called autism. His family got him help. And slowly, he learned how to live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
Welcome back. Joining us today, we have Marywood sophomore Ryan Calamia. Thank you again for coming on the show with us and talking with us. So I kind of want to segue now into more of your involvement with Student Government Association and Student Ambassadorship. Can you just restate your position for SGA?
I'm the class of 2019 senator. So I help out with our class specifically, as well as helping out with the SGA as a whole.
So I recently saw that you guys went on a conference. Could you tell us where that was and what you did there?
That conference was amazing. It was the American Student Government Association. And so a bunch of college student governments came together to this conference in Jersey City, New Jersey. And we all talked about our SGAs and how they function and everything. And we got a lot of tips from the SGAs alone, as well as there were four different speakers, and they each talked about something else to help improve our student government, which was really cool.
So what exactly do you see in the future for the class of 2019 specifically?
I think we can see really awesome improvements to Marywood coming up. It's going to be really cool and exciting, and so I'm super excited for the next 2 years.
Great. So you actually just, I guess, started back up what Do You Want Wednesdays?
Yes.
Can you just tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, so What Do You Want Wednesdays, we recently brought that back. So any concerns or problems that you see on Marywood, or even if you just have a suggestion to give student government, just fill out a slip of paper when we're there. And put it in the suggestion box, and then we'll bring them to our next student government and we'll talk about them and everything and see what we can do on our level or help the higher ups.
So what do you think would, I mean, because you're a senator, so you kind of see everything kind of from a different perspective as students do. What do you think could be the biggest change at Marywood?
I think the biggest change on like a kind of like platonic level is student positivity, I guess, about the school. Student like school pride and everything. We recently started a new hashtag, MU Pacer Pride. So any pictures taken on Marywood, use it, and it's an awesome way for people, incoming classes or people looking at the school can like find it on Facebook and Instagram, and it'll help enrollment and stuff. So
I was actually thinking about wearing my Marywood University sweatshirt today, but I didn't want Rachel to like kill me or something.
Oh, never.
Yeah. Well, we'll wear it to work tomorrow.
I mean, I'm very excited. Now, Ryan, I mean, there's something we haven't talked about yet today. It is your birthday.
Right. It is my birthday.
And we are very excited that you actually took time out of your day.
Your special day to be with us.
To join us.
Yeah. And, so we have a pretty big surprise for
you. While we are running out of time.
Yeah.
My wonderful stage manager, we have this wonderful cake for you.
We're gonna slowly pass it down.
Now, we were told by millions of people to not drop this cake on you.
Okay.
So we promise we won't.
For the studio.
But this is your birthday cake.
Thank you.
Happy birthday.
And we also have a card from all of us here at Lady Day Marywood.
From us at Lady Day Marywood.
Thank you, guys.
So this is for you.
That's so nice. Thank you, guys.
Thank you guys so much for joining us. We hope you have a very, very special birthday.
Thank you.
And thank you again for coming out the time. Coming up next, we have another guest, so stay with us when we'll be right back on Late Night Marywood.
This is the story of a boy who is very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where nothing could get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. It made him feel uncomfortable. One day, he found out he had something called autism. His family got him help. And slowly, he learned how to live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
They said I have troll teeth.
That my voice sounded like a possessed baby doll.
That no one would ever love someone as stupid as me.
That I was fat. Ugly.
Disgusting.
The effect of bullying is potent.
We will no longer be the silent majority.
Now, when you see online bullying, there's something you can do about it.
We're gonna take action with the eye.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness, and so are you.
So who's gonna do what?
I'll pack the dead batteries.
Great.
I'll only put what I don't need into a duffel bag.
Perfect, that's totally unhelpful.
No problem.
Meanwhile, I will try to comfort everyone by speaking in a calm voice.
And who is going to handle supplies?
I can forget to do a list for us.
Thanks, pal.
We couldn't be any less prepared. I'm proud of you guys.
Talk to your kids about who to call, where to meet, what to pack. Visit ready.gov/kids for tips and information.
Alvin and the Chipmunks want to remind you, bacteria can hide in food and make you ill.
Wow.
But you can keep bacteria from ruining your day with four simple steps. Clean.
I'm waiting for the rinse cycle.
Separate. Cook.
Fire in the hole.
And chill.
We chipmunks are notoriously tidy.
Check your steps. The road trip to food safety starts at foodsafety.gov.
There's one thing you can never have sex without.
It's not something you buy.
Or something you take.
In fact, there's only one way to get it.
It has to be given to you, freely.
It's consent.
Because sex without it isn't sex.
It's rape. Consent.
If you don't get it, you don't get it.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Right, mi cariño. So like I said, everything I learned about cooking, I learned from grandma's empanadas. Shall we go again?
Yep.
Mix the beef with the onions with the peppers with the paprika, the garlic with the oregano with the cumin. Got it?
Got it.
Throw in the olives, stir, season, stir again, pour out the flour, roll out the dough, make a circle, drop in a fistful of filling, fold over, press down, and ta-da!
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day making sure they brush is easier, and it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain.
Welcome back to Late Night Marywood. Our next guest for the night is a singer, a solo singer-songwriter from Clark Summit. His one album, One More, just hit a one-year anniversary. Please welcome James Barrett. Aside from being a solo artist, he's also the frontman of alternative band Embera. Please welcome James Barrett.
Thanks again for joining us, coming all the way here. We really appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Yeah, so can you tell us a little bit about how you got started with playing instruments and being a musician?
When I was a kid, my dad played guitar, and then my brother drummed, and I wanted to do something a little different than the two of them, so I picked up bass when I was in third grade.
Wow,
and then
that's
taught myself
weird.
Guitar. Yeah.
Nice. So how long exactly have you been playing for then? Okay. Every instrument, basically.
So third grade, that's about a year ago. No, so third grade, that was 2007. Nice. So yeah, like probably almost like 10 years now. Yeah, 10 years, yeah, it's 2017.
So you started with bass and then you
played
guitar.
Yeah, then I started playing guitar and then just from there on, you know.
Awesome, have you learned any other instruments?
I played upright, like upright bass for my orchestra when I was in high school. And then I can kind of play ukulele, but I don't really consider that, like I don't really play it enough. I can drum a bit, only because my brother drums though, but that's mainly it.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So your family's pretty...
Yeah, me, my brother, my dad, and I. So we're pretty much the three for music in my family, at least.
So can you tell us a little bit about how you got started in your band?
Well, my band, Embera, it was originally just me. And then I wanted to not release something acoustic for once, because everything I do is usually just by myself. So it started off as just me, and then I recorded a couple songs and had my friend drum and my friend Dave do like one guitar part, and then eventually we just ended up all becoming a band because I didn't want to be me anymore.
What exactly created that name? Like, what inspired that?
Well, when I was 14 or 15, 2012, I went to the Panama Rainforest with my school. Mm-hmm. It was a couple kids got selected, and I was one of them. Mm-hmm. And we stayed with an indigenous tribe. It was the first tribe we stayed with us was Embera-Kara, and then the second tribe was Power-Puru. But I really like the first Embera-Kara was what like really hit me, and I eventually got that tattooed on me. And then I was trying to figure out a name for it, and I eventually one night just looked at my wrist and realized like that's what I wanted to name it. So.
So for our audience who may not know, what is this type of sound that you're?
Embera, I guess, is just like, it's this alternative, like, not punk, I guess, but like alternative rock in a way. It's just kind of like, I guess, big sounding. I guess that's the best way I could describe it.
So how did you start to venture away from that a little bit into doing your own solo stuff?
Well, my guitarist, David Sirkanich, who is the best guitarist on the planet, I always say that. He went to Syracuse for school, and I was like, okay, I can't not do anything for a year. So I was like, I'm just going to write a solo record, so which is I always wanted to do it. And then I decided to start doing that, and I released a song called The Window, and it was like, it kind of changed the whole like aspect of everything in my life, and people started like actually listening to me. And after that, I was like, okay, I really didn't need to focus on doing this. So I released a solo record, and then now it's just, it kind of let it, everything kind of came from that, just from me having an idea, and now it's all I do.
So when have you actually started publicly performing? How long have you
been? It was 2010, I think. It was like February 21st or 2nd, 2010. And I played at Eleanor Rigby's in Carbondale when that was a venue. And then I think I was 12 at the time. And then since then, I've been playing and hopefully getting better.
Really, really fun. So your most recent one more is celebrating its
Actually, One More came out. It came out March 1st, 2016. And then that led to me recording another EP in the summer, which is, EP is just like a, not an album. It's just like a little shorter. And I released that called the Metamorphosis EP. That was September 2nd. I recorded it in the summer, though. So those are my two most recent things.
What would you say is your favorite part about like recording music and making new music? What do you just love about it?
I hate recording music because it's just the most stressful stressful part about doing anything. I like writing music because for the longest time I always would write, you know, when you write for yourself to, you know, like to clear your head and then hope that it does something for somebody else in the meantime. And that was like, I never thought I'd ever do anything for anybody else. I always thought it was just me writing because I knew I wanted to do it. And then when I started releasing my own music, like from that CD, people started telling me that they connected to it, which was something I never thought would happen. So that's a big part of it. Mm-hmm. So.
So in like a very brief general statement, what would you say you want people to get from this album?
Just something, you know what I mean? Whether it's, I just want people to feel something, and hopefully, you know, something positive. Because a lot of people like told me that they really connected to it, and it, like, some people were telling me like it helped them get through stuff, and that to me, like, it's just crazy to me. I mean, I'm so like, you know, I'm so thankful to hear that. It's just, it's like overwhelming sometimes to hear that, but hopefully, you know, someone feels something, and it helps them, you know, either like their, make their day better or anything, you know, that's what I want.
Wow, really nice.
Well, we are excited to learn more about your sound and your music altogether. We will be taking a short break, and then we'll be coming back with more with James about his new or year-old album now, One More, right after this.
Right, mi cariño. So like I said, everything I learned about cooking, I learned from grandma's empanadas. Shall we go again?
Yep.
Mix beef with the onions with the peppers with the paprika with the garlic with the oregano with the cumin. Got it?
Got it.
Throw in the olives, stir, season, stir again, pour out the flour, roll out the dough, make a circle, drop in a fistful of filling, fold over, press down, and ta-da!
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day making sure they brush is easier, and it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain.
You think getting dumped by text is harsh? Try getting dumped by a tennis ball. My ex-owner drove me out to the woods, yelled fetch, and by the time I brought the ball back, he was gone. Yeah, I was pissed. But the folks at the shelter helped me let go of my anger. I learned coping skills, like taking it to the hole. Boom! Now I'm ready to fetch again. But how about I throw and you run and get it?
Todd's a great guy. I mean, look at him. What a sweetheart. Attaboy. Wait, Todd, what are you doing? How totally selfish and un-Todd-like of you. Come on, Todd. Come on, man.
You're doing great. We're gonna try this again, okay?
Okay.
Wheels, pedals, handlebar, brakes. Sit up straight, keep your weight in the center, keep your eyes on the road, hands on the grips, button the seat. If we feel ourselves falling, what do we do?
Just keep pedaling.
Good girl. Now remember, it's all about balance and steering. Steer with your hands, steer with your body. Steer into the corners and you stay out of trouble. And the bell's your buddy, so go ahead and ding that. All right, ready? Here we go. Pedal, honey, pedal. There you go, you're a bike rider.
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day, making sure they brush, is easier. And it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain.
Welcome back to Late Night Marywood. In the studio right now, we are joined with musician James Barrett.
So I kind of want to move on now to your actual music. We kind of briefly talked about it before the break. Can you just basically go into your now 1 year anniversary album, One More?
Okay. So One More, it was just the way I got the title, I guess, is I used to have another band with my friend Terry called Shop Local when we were like 14. We thought it was a cool name because there's like a picture, it's like spray painted somewhere in Scranton. We wrote a song when I was a junior, and we were like, dude, we should like write another like record before you go back to school. And we never did it, but we wrote a song called One More because we wanted to do one more record. And then I really liked the song, and I was like, I asked him if I could use it for my record and if he could play on it. And then we just stuck with the title. But it's just a lot of songs I pretty much wrote from my freshman year to my senior year in high school.
Wow, and that's pretty early.
So they're pretty, I think the oldest song goes back, probably 2014, so my sophomore year, I think.
So what are some of your like inspirationals and like some of the meanings behind some of the songs?
Well, I mean, it was just about my life, pretty much. Like, I just write about like what's going on in my life. It's kind of, I always wish I could write about like a lot of people, like they write from the perspective of somebody else, and I've never been good at that. It's something I'd like to get better at. But it's a lot of stuff, just really what was going on in my life, and I kind of take really personal aspects of my life, like certain things that, like, if you're friends with me, you know what I'm talking about. But a lot of times people don't. The whole song One More is about like, every time people come over to my house, they have to walk around my backyard because I have four dogs and they're really loud. So I have everyone go through the back door so they don't have to deal with my dogs. And that was like pretty much the whole song is just about everyone kind of just coming to my basement, which it sounds like so random, but it's like, it was like a huge part of my life growing up is having people, like telling people walk around the back.
Have you ever kind of had that emotion outside of your, I guess, your own body when you're performing?
There's times where like, I guess it just depends on like what I'm feeling that day, I guess, you know. But yeah, there's a lot of times where I'm playing it and like it feels different when you play it live. You know what I mean? It's one thing like hearing it on a recording, but like being able to play it live and like they're like just engraved into my head, these songs, so like I never forget them. It's a really cool feeling, I guess, you know.
Wow. So what are some of your accomplishments or what you're looking forward to 2017, I guess?
I'm looking forward to now is I want to release another record in May, and after that, just tour a lot in the summer. I have a couple like small runs, like 3 days or 4 days, like in the next couple months. But I like to do like a week or 2 weeks in the summer, and something just to promote it. And that's pretty much where I'm at now. Hopefully, just release something and just keep doing it and building it.
So, are you doing that with your band or more solo?
Well, my band is releasing an EP in the next month or so, whenever we finish recording it. And that's the problem, recording is what's always the issue.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But after that, I'm gonna start working on my solo record probably within the next 2 weeks or so, recording it.
Now we kind of talked about the sound of your own voice. What about the sound of the actual band? I mean, with this new EP, what should listeners expect to hear?
It's heavier than my acoustic stuff for sure, but not like, you know, anything where it's like, you know, I'm screaming. Except one song, actually, but it's a lot heavier and a lot, I guess, it's very like emotional, I guess. It's just like I say big sounding just because we try to make the recording sound as like big and live as possible. So it's a lot different, but I think it's not, it's like, it's like a perfect balance of being like not heavy enough where everyone can kind of enjoy it, and like heavy enough where like if you listen to heavier music growing up, it's, you know, not like out of your comfort zone. Mm-hmm. So that's what I hope.
Well, yeah.
So I mean, we have one more question for you.
Yeah.
In 3 words or more, or less,
What
would you say has been the most personal song that has really spoken to you, not only you, but your listeners as well?
A song I wrote or a song in...
In general, yeah, something that has really driven you and kind of driven your music altogether.
There's a band called... this is way more than 3 words. There's
okay.
a band called Listener. There's a song called You Were a House on Fire. That's a song that really, they're like a spoken word band that definitely impacted the way I write music a lot. Just the imagery and stuff is what really gets it.
Great. Well, when we come back, you will be performing a new single or one of your singles for us, and we're very excited. So stay tuned right here on Late Night Marywood.
You know what, guys? There's a lot of tree branches and dry brush over here. We should probably move the bonfire over there.
I'm guessing Smokey liked that idea.
You've messed up your son's haircut.
Mom?
Do you A, try to fix it?
Like it never happened.
B, work with what you got? Or C, show solidarity?
Thank you, babe.
As a parent, there are no perfect answers. But you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
There are 16 million children struggling with hunger in America. That's 1 in 5 daughters, sons, neighbors, and classmates who don't know where their next meal is coming from. Yet billions of pounds of good food go to waste every year. It's time we do something about it. Feeding America is a nationwide network of food banks that helps provide meals to millions of kids and families in need. Visit feedingamerica.org to help them feed even more. Together, we can solve hunger. Together, we're feeding America.
This is the story of a boy who is very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where nothing could get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. It made him feel uncomfortable. One day, he found out he had something called autism. His family got him help. And slowly, he learned how to live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
They said I have troll teeth.
That my voice sounded like a possessed baby doll.
That no one would ever love someone as stupid as me.
That I was fat, ugly.
Disgusting.
The effect of bullying is potent.
We will no longer be the silent majority.
Now, when you see online bullying, there's something you can do about it.
We're gonna take action with the eye.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness, and so are you.
So who's going to do what?
I'll pack the dead batteries.
Great.
I'll only put what I don't need into a duffel bag.
Perfect. That's totally unhelpful.
No problem.
Meanwhile, I will try to comfort everyone by speaking in a calm voice.
And who is going to handle supplies?
I can forget to do a list for us.
Thanks, pal.
We couldn't be any less prepared. I'm proud of you guys.
Talk to your kids about who to call, where to meet, what to pack. Visit ready.gov/kids for tips and information.
Performing live his single Used to Remind Me of the Sky from his album One More, please welcome James Barrett.
Mm-hmm.
just remind me of the sky. 'Cause I never understood the weather. I never understood a lot of you. But I was in love with what I knew. And I remember there were days when it rained, but I didn't mind. Because you were the rays behind the clouds and the sound of the water. Sky and these days I wake up from the sun, reminded how you are no longer by my side.
Don't go anywhere. We will have another performance right here after this.
So who's going to do what?
I'll pack the dead batteries.
Great.
I'll only put what I don't need into a duffel bag.
Perfect. That's totally unhelpful.
No problem.
Meanwhile, I will try to comfort everyone by speaking in a calm voice.
And who is going to handle supplies?
I can forget to do a list for us.
Thanks, pal.
We couldn't be any less prepared.
I'm proud of you guys.
Talk to your kids about who to call, where to meet, what to pack. Visit ready.gov/kids for tips and information.
Chipmunks want to remind you, bacteria can hide in food and make you ill.
Wow.
But you can keep bacteria from ruining your day with four simple steps. Clean.
I'm waiting for the rim cycle.
Separate. Cook.
Fire in the hole.
And chill.
We chipmunks are notoriously tidy.
Check your steps. The road trip to food safety starts at foodsafety.gov.
There's one thing you can never have sex without.
It's not something you buy.
Or something you take.
In fact, there's only one way to get it.
It has to be given to you, freely.
It's consent.
Because sex without it isn't sex.
It's rape. Consent.
If you don't get it, you don't get it. It's on us to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
And I'm Marywood. Performing now is Metamorphosis. Please welcome back James Barrett.
If you looked at my spine, you would find vertebrae out of line. And so am I. But insisting you and I are still the same gets harder every day. When I forget our names, there's nights when my bed won't let me sleep. There's days when I'm too stubborn to be the friend that you need. I've been so busy I forgot to call, but I feel I still do nothing at all. nights where we write to survive the winter that didn't come. But I'm bleeding and I'm freezing inside, but that's my DNA. I'll use that excuse again. I miss you every day when I wake up, but you were gone before the sun could ever run. I'm older now and there are things that I would like to stay the same, but I'm metamorphic and changing every day.
We are out of time for tonight, but make sure to go listen to James' album on iTunes, Spotify, Google Play, or Apple Music starting March 8th.
We will see you all right here on Late Night Marywood. Next week is on spring break, so we're going to be back here with Sister John Michelle Southwick and Natalie Burke on March 20th. So, something to look forward to.
Good luck on midterms, everybody, and enjoy your spring break. Make it a great 2 weeks.
So catch up on Netflix, sleep, all that time with your friends.
Do everything you want to do, basically. Hey, and you can even re-watch all of Late Night Marywood. Make sure to go like us on TV Marywood's Facebook page, our YouTube page. Go follow us. Catch up. Hey, even share with your friends.
Yep. Sounds like a great time. Definitely do. So thanks again for joining us. See you next time.
Have a great one, everyone.